It's a desert out there, and we all know it gets hot here. But living in the middle of a city means you're dealing with hotter temperatures than the suburbs. It's the urban heat island effect. An urban heat island is the phenomenon when a city experiences warmer temperatures than nearby rural areas.
It might not seem like that makes a lot of difference because we are in the Mojave Desert, and it gets hot here, and that is just the reality of it. But it is noticeably and measurably hotter in downtown versus Summerlin or Centennial Hills.
Marco Velada, a sustainability expert with the City of Las Vegas, defines the urban heat island for us.
It's when we have a lot of concrete, asphalt, glass that's reflecting heat back up into the atmosphere immediately around the city.
The difference has to do with how well the surfaces in each environment absorb and hold heat. Trees provide shade, and grass doesn't absorb as much heat, whereas concrete, asphalt, and buildings do. Where buildings are more concentrated, the heat island is hotter. In places like Summerlin or Centennial Hills, where there are more green spaces and the houses are more spread out, the temperature is a few degrees cooler. Outside a town where there are no structures is typically a couple degrees cooler than even the suburbs. The City of Las Vegas is making an effort to curb this effect as much as possible. One thing that helps reduce temperatures is planting drought-tolerant trees in these urban areas.
One of the things that's essential to that and really help make a vibrant downtown environment is having tree-lined streets. And that's something that we included in the downtown master plan, is to really increase the tree canopy throughout downtown Las Vegas and the medical district and the historic west side.
Streets and sidewalk, they absorb heat, and trees do a good job of stopping the sunlight from getting down and collecting in there and then radiating out at night.
Brad Dossler is the city's urban forester who is responsible for managing and maintaining the city's 45,000 trees.
Trees just make cities livable. Like, we want green spaces, we want nature. We want to live in a built environment because it's comfortable for us, but trees make that area comfortable. So I don't think anybody wants to just live with brick walls and sidewalks and streets. Like, we want all these amenities, but I think trees make those places nice to live in.
Dossler identifies parking lots as a problem when it comes to the heat island.
Parking lots are an issue. It's a really hard place to plant a tree, and so we're focused on that. I think that's important to kind of shade asphalt, and we're trying to reduce the urban heat island.
In addition to adding trees, having buildings with white roofs, such as the roof of City Hall, can help reduce the heat island. White reflects more of the sun's rays instead of absorbing and holding them like the darker colors. This can help a building stay cooler and reduce the amount the air conditioning has to kick on, which of course is good for all of our power bills.
It's not going to be like a light switch where all of a sudden the whole city is shaded, but we're going to continue to work at it, and hopefully over time we get a good result.
And we want to make sure that Las Vegas in the future is a livable, equitable, healthy, resilient, and innovative place for years to come.